skincare. Skincare. Amazing. You literally had that kind of sexy little glow. I know. You either do the finger or the palm.
Yeah, I know. It's like one or the other. My mum's not too impressed.
Are you quick? Are you somebody who just literally washes their face with one?
I can't use anything too harsh because my skin is so sensitive. So I literally use.
Go on, tell us. Secrets are coming out now, guys.
I use I think it's CeraVe or Cetaphil.
Okay.
When people have acne, they use it because it's got nothing in it. So that and
hold
then...
up. So you've got some special treatment for acne and you have no acne.
No.
Is this a secret to your amazing skin?
It's just face wash and then just basically stuff. I only use Mario Badescu face wash.
Yeah.
And then all my moisturizers have nothing in them. So it's just just got nothing in it. Skin's not that good. I think I feel like in pictures it can look better than...
Sorry, I'm sitting next to you. Good skin. What about me and all your history? I'm not trying to burn myself, but I can let it go. The first time I heard your music, I straight away was I didn't see any visuals, I just heard the music, and I was going on my walk in the morning. And you almost made, it was saving grace, you made me want to cry.
Aww.
I don't know if it was because I was going through so much in my life, but I feel like it's the type of song that genuinely hits you. And if you listen to music through your headphones, it's so very personal.
Yeah.
And a lot of your songs after that, I caught up on everything I'd missed. And then I found out how old you were, and Grace, I cannot believe you're writing songs like this.
Epic.
It's where does that come from?
People are always wait, how old are you? Yeah, I'm not old.
You're 20, is that right?
Yeah, I just turned 21.
Happy birthday. Thank you. So where does that come from though? Because you write in such a sophisticated, almost I've gone through so much shit way.
Yeah, well, it's because I have a bit, but I started writing songs when I was 13 about the fact that I grew up with a single mum and I was very, very confused as a kid as to why my dad wasn't around. I just couldn't work it out. I just didn't understand. So I was very angry, very frustrated as a child. And then I got to 13 and my mum met her partner, who's my stepdad. And I I don't know. He was a musician and he just sat me down and he was like, you have so much that you've never said. You have so much that you need to process and get off your chest.
This is 13?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, 12, 13. He's like, you just need to get it off your chest. Here's a guitar. It was literally a £30 guitar from a chat, the Sue Ryder.
I don't get. I just love that you had a dad that somebody that would do that for you.
But the thing is, I'd never had that before. I'd never had, especially a male figure in my life that would ever do that for me. And I just I went from hating him to loving him in the space of 30 seconds.
You literally music put you together.
Yeah, exactly. 100%.
And did you did he teach you or did you just buy it and he didn't know how to play?
He's amazing, amazing musician. But he bought me the guitar and taught me three chords and then gave me a capo and I wrote every song with the same three chords, putting the capo up and down the fret of the guitar. And it was just a tool that he gave me that allowed me to talk about things that I'd never spoken about before.
Did you fall in love with the guitar straight away or was it something that... So sometimes people get instruments and they have a little go and they're like,
no.
Nah.
No, I fell straight away. I wrote my first... I was very competitive as a kid. I was a tennis player growing up.
Oh, and... God, I know little boys are tennis players. He's 12 and he's I said, how good are you? He said... 9 out of 10. Tennis players are different types of individuals.
Yeah, tennis players are insane and that's why I stopped playing tennis. But my stepdad, I was very competitive as a kid and he was write me a song in a week. Okay. And I was okay, I've got this. And I went and wrote this song called Blank White Page, which wasn't even about anything. It was about the fact that I couldn't write a song and the fact that I was looking at a blank white page. Mm. But I just wanted to do it in the week. And then after I wrote that song, I just fell in love with...
Right.
I'm an only child as well, so I just sit in my bedroom with my guitar on photo booth and just write songs for hours and hours and hours, and I just haven't stopped since then.
So would you say music is your passion, saviour, everything? Because it feels you've vented so much into it. And now you've been 21 and you explaining that makes sense why you're writing these sorts of songs.
Yeah, 100%. I know a lot of people say music is therapy and I totally do believe that. And
me too.
That is what it is for me anyway. It's I'm very lucky for the fact that I'm sat here right now and I'm getting to do this and I love it. And I would have never thought I'd be here when I wrote my first song. I would have hoped that, I don't think I would have even hoped. I don't think I knew that this was what I wanted to do. But I started writing songs because I had a very troubled childhood. But not even just with myself, I was very confused. And so... I don't know, it's just, it's amazing.
I mean, it's pretty awesome that you are, so open.
Yeah.
It's so good that you're sharing. Sometimes musicians, especially, that you adore, that make this music, that really touches you, they don't talk to you about it. Yeah. They very rarely talk about it. They just leave it in their music. And I think it's so dope that you actually are writing such personal, hardcore lyrics that really touch you, and something really traumatic happened to you in your life, but then you can sit here next to me and you can share that story. Mm. Does that mean that you're fully in recovery? You feel like you're in the best place you've ever been?
I definitely feel like since I wrote my first song, I'm like a changed person in the best way possible. It still affects me though, like in like the decisions that I make and the way that I feel and the way that I react to things. But I think talking about it is a great thing, and I want to encourage other people my age and older or younger to feel like they can talk about it too, whether it's like physically talking about it or writing it down. I just think it's so powerful. And all the artists that I grew up loving were artists that were like brutally honest and kind of said what it was that they were going through. And I appreciated that and I loved that. And I definitely, in my music and me as a person, I want to achieve the same thing.
Who touched you then growing up? Was there one
person? So many people. Lauren, I love Lauren Hill.
Me too. It was the anniversary of Miss Education. I know. Only 20 years or something the other day.
Like a couple of days ago. Yeah. Yeah, no, that was amazing.
That album is timeless. You can see it is incredible.
It is incredible. And my mom used to play that all the time in the car. Alicia Keys, I've loved forever. Nina Simone is someone that I just like, it was more her voice. The fact that maybe she didn't write the song, but the way that she sang it, it was like she'd written the
beautiful
song.
Beautiful,
It meant everything to her. Yeah, she's just incredible. And I think all those artists, it was emotional and it was honest. And I think that's why people connected. And I think that's like, that's what music's for. Yeah. I think like bringing people together and connecting people. And
I think it's a really interesting time and a good time, because I've noticed that a lot of the new young female artists, you've all come together.
Yeah.
And it's not like fake where people are like, oh, I'm going to stand next to this girl because she's really hot right now. You know, when you're at school or whatever and everyone's
Like... Yeah, like popular
thing. Yeah, like, exactly. Yeah. It actually feels like, especially in your case with Jorja, even with Dua, Mabel, I feel like it's genuine love, because none of you lot really have to shout each other out, but you're choosing to because you've clearly connected with one another.
100%.
What, individually, starting with Dua, I know you share management, and I have to say, her success is so well deserved. Just
it is, she's amazing.
How hard she's worked to get there. What has she perhaps shared with you, or been around her that you picked up on? Do you think
she is just incredibly supportive of me, and it's so genuine. Like, no one asks her to do anything. I'll see that she's like tagged me in something or posted something about me, and I'm like, wow, thank you, but like, you didn't have to do that. She's just a great person. Also, I always forget that she's only like a year older than me, and I'm like, I'm so mature.
and she does have this killer voice, and she loves soul music.
Yeah, and she works so unbelievably hard. Right. Like, so she's never at home. She's always away. She's always doing something new. She's always working.
I feel like she's balling though, because I feel like she takes everyone with her.
Yeah.
Like, she must be doing so well because she has all her friend circle, boyfriend, family, and it's like,
and they're all great people as well. Like, all of the people she surrounds herself with are like fantastic, like amazing people. We were just in Kosovo.
How was that? Because I know that was really important for her family. Like, for you going there and experiencing something like that, how was it?
It was amazing. And also like seeing how important it was to her and her dad and her siblings and her mum, and like being with everyone and kind of, and all the people of Kosovo, like they'd never had an experience like that before, and to be a part of it was just amazing. And it was like the craziest show I've
ever
done.
How many people did you play to? With a lot, right?
Well, I thought it was 12,000, but then people are saying different numbers, but it was definitely over 12,000. And yeah, it was crazy. I walked out on stage. I had like a 10 p.m. slot, which would never happen in my career right now.
Stop.
But
you're headlining your own tour soon.
Yeah,
you're gonna
be on stage. Yeah, I will. No, but like 10 o'clock in front of 12,000 people.
Yeah, it's insane.
And I walked out, and like everyone just started screaming, and I just got so overwhelmed. And I was actually saying earlier, like, I sang Silhouette and I kind of got a bit like excited because I felt that everyone was on my side, and I was like, can everyone like shine their torches? Because you know, you see it on like,
that moment for my IG.
Yeah, like, it has gone from that moment where Silhouette for me is a song about feeling lonely and feeling on my own, and like,
as you switch because of the reaction you get with the crowd.
And then like being in front of all those people singing the song and them all like joining in with me and putting their lights up just kind of went from like the song about being lonely.
Yeah.
But I'm like surrounded by so many
thousands of people.
Yeah, it was like this weird thing in my head, and I was like trying to carry on singing, but like thinking about the fact that this is happening. So you are.
I love it. You are so like, I just like, it's, you're so very different to your music. And I know that's such a
people always
like,
say that
judgmental thing. Not even judgmental, it's like a prick, like I shouldn't even be saying that, because how can I decide by your music who you, but you're such a bubbly person.
Yeah, I really am.
And you're full of so much life, and I feel like this music that you've written, I'm curious about the next project, because now you're in this place.
Yeah.
Are you already writing?
I've always been like this. Yeah. This is the thing. Like, I've always been a very, like, loud, sociable, like,
we're just literally, like, sexy Sade looking like it's a bit mysterious.
Yeah, but my mum has always said, like, I remember, she told me when I was about 6 years old, she took me to a family, like, dinner party, and there was, like, this girl, there's, like, couple there.
Yeah.
And I just sat down with them. I was like, so what do you do for a living? And, like, I've always been very interested in, like, people.
Oh, you were like a little nosy beaker.
Yeah. No, but, like, at five, like, who even thinks to ask that question? That's just so weird.
She could be a host one day as well. Yeah. Watch out. Jorja.
Yeah.
She's another person that's always shouting you out, and you've shouted her out as well. I think in a lot of ways, you're both going through a similar journey. I feel like Georgia's kind of been pushed to the forefront much quicker. Yeah. But musically, I think you're kind of both at the same sort of point. Yeah. You've had an EP out. She's put her project out. I would love to know what your chats are like in person.
I think she's great. Do you know what? We've only met twice now.
Okay.
But she is so... We have the same hair, girl.
I know. I saw the picture. I was like, they've got their pose on.
Yeah. Yeah, but... No, I think she's great. I really... Yeah. She's a really humble person as well. I feel like she's very grateful to be where she is, and, like, to support other artists is, like, an amazing thing.
And the Mabel tour, how was that? Because, again, I feel like you guys are new, young girls. It just must be the best time to connect.
I think she's great. Yeah? I think, yeah, she's lovely. And her whole crew are so nice as well. So we just had a really nice time.
What about your circle? Like, today you've got one person here from the team who seems lovely. You don't have a ton of people with you.
Yeah.
How is the friend circle like? Because I thought it was so cool that you took a couple of your friends to festivals.
Yeah.
They looked like they were living the best life.
And they were like, oh my gosh, because we'd go to festivals when we were younger and actually not shower for, like, a week. And they were like, oh my God, this is really nice. Like, free Nando's.
Love it. But do you have, like, does everyone check out what's in the diary and then you have to divvy things up to what people can come to
No, well,
how does it work?
It's kind of, I don't know. It's just like, if I'm going somewhere, I'll be like, do you want to come with? And if they can, it's like, it's cool. But with my Saving Grace video, I had four of my best friends in that and my mum. So that sort of thing is really great for me. Like, that song is about my friends and my mum and all the people that kind of, like, surrounded me and kind of lifted me up. And to have them in that video was just, like, the most powerful thing. And they loved getting their nails done and their makeup done. But it was also just, like, it was so nice.
No, I like the picture, the whole image of them all together. I think your mum, like, she's either cringing or she's loving it.
Oh, my God, she hated it.
Did she? Oh,
she loved it. She loved the sentiment. She loved being there. Yeah. But I think just the whole being in front of a camera, she was like, I was trying to look smouldering. But, like, when you're over 50, it's just really difficult. And I was like, no, mum, you looked amazing.
How important has she been to you?
She is, honestly, I can't even put it into words. Mm-hmm. Like, she is more than a rock to me. She was confronted with me as like when I was born, and she's brought me up on her own. Yeah, she's literally brought me up on her own my whole life. Like, she's just amazing. She's worked so hard.
When I don't know if you've had that moment yet, but has there been a moment where you've both got really emotional with everything that's happening? But even with your stepfather as well, going from being that girl with the top writing, like, has it happened where you've all kind of sort of cried together?
Yeah, because especially, like, my mum, we did The Great Escape this year, and both of the shows my mum came to, but I wrote this song called Fight For You about her, and we sat, well, I was on stage, and I looked out at the crowd, and I could just see her, and I was like, this just feels so right. We're in Brighton, where I moved when I was 9, and my mum's right there, like, in front of me, and I was like, this song's for my mum, and we just both had it was the most emotional. I just started crying. She started crying, because it was just like, that is what music is to me. It's like, me and my people around me, and an emotional thing, and an outlet, and we've kind of, me and my mum together, have made a really, hopefully, good thing out of a bad situation. And I think for us, like, that's enough. Like, took the air right out my lungs. Oh, tell me why hurt on me. What did I do for you to wreck it all? Oh, Lord, it's not my fault.
That's amazing. And you know what's amazing also about your music? Like, you, to me, you stand apart from everybody else because your music is soulful, but it's also amazing pop songs. And the first time I heard you, and I hope you don't mind me doing comparisons, I know people hate that, especially musicians. I was like, she makes me feel how Emily Sandé makes me feel.
Okay.
Because Emily, to me, like, she makes soul music, but she makes pop soul timeless songs.
Yeah.
Anyone and everyone, whatever genre they're into, can listen to an Emily Sandé song and say, that shit is, like, timeless and beautiful. And I feel like you're doing that as well.
For me, 100%, I think she's great. And I think for my music and the biggest thing for me is that as many people as possible connect to what I'm saying and kind of put their lives onto what it could. Something, a song can mean, like, Why Her Not Me means what it does to me, but I want other people to kind of be able to put their own lives onto them.
You're about to go on tour,
yeah,
headlining your own tour, which has got to be so, so sick.
Yeah.
Because you've toured with everyone else, so you know what you want.
Yeah, now. I'm literally like, I can't even. I try not to think
about
it. What's
it like, so, and can you ask for different things? Like your name on the drum kit? I don't know. Like,
I have my name on the drum kit already.
Oh, you have it already? Okay, amazing.
So happy about it.
All right, so like, are there things that you've already got in your mind that you were waiting for this moment to be able to do it?
Yeah, I think we're gonna do some merch, which I'm really excited about.
Okay, cute. What are you thinking?
I don't know if I should.
I so feel like you have to do like the sleeveless crop denims because you wear them all the time.
I don't know. My god sister is actually like, she designs things and she kind of draws things and does sketches. So I think we're gonna collaborate on something together.
Amazing.
Which, like, I've known her since
the day she was born. Proper collection.
No, or just like just pieces. One thing. But I think I would love to keep on doing. Like, she's incredibly talented, and I think that would, like, for the both of us, like our little. Yeah.
I feel like you love fashion though, and you seem to like really play with block colours.
Yeah, I'm like so like that.
But I love it, especially when you wear the red and stuff. And it's also kind of 80s as well, but like you do the tailoring, then you do like, even when you're wearing the cash, you've still got that kind of tailored look.
Yeah.
Are you really into the whole fashion side of what you do as well? Because I feel like musicians, when you're a creative person, you're in some way, all these things kind of overlap.
Yeah, I definitely am, but I always have been. Like, I remember being at school and like all the girls in my year would like shop in Topshop, and I'd always like go thrifting and like find
gems.
Stuff. But yeah, I just like try, I found like this really sick leather jacket, like bright blue leather jacket when I was younger.
Yeah.
That I just love now and I wear now. But yeah, I've always been into it, but it's not really, I definitely say I enjoy it, but it's kind of like a secondary thing.
Yeah, and the show.
Yeah.
Do you know what that stage is going to look like? Do you know the set list? Do you know if what you want to do? Are you going to bring guests out?
Well, yeah, we just announced today that Heiress Robes is supporting, who I think is extremely talented. So
I'm
going to
check him out because I saw you tweet that actually.
Yeah, he's really good. And yeah, I don't know yet. I don't know actually. I'm having a think about it at the moment.
Excited or nervous? Because must be lots of anticipation for this, because it's a headline show.
Yeah, both. I've only done one headline show before, and I've toured a lot with other people. So, it's going to be extremely surreal, and I can't wait. No, I won't lay low. You gave my soul, I'm not giving it no more.